biology student. graduate student, and he's doing research on the role of science supplanting the role of religion as being the source of answers to life's deepest questions. And he's curious about this, and he's probing this. And you might wonder, well, he's Matthew McConaughey. You can't have him in a movie and be celibate. So they cover that, okay? So it's, well, I'm a man of cloth without the cloth. See, so he's studying theology just for the philosophy of it, not for the practice of it, okay? Okay. So, here's a scene. Now, he's basically reporting on what scientists are doing. This is the closest he has yet to sit next to Jodie Foster. And you see that there's not much distance there, right? And he's like kind of mean. He's kind of... All right, so what happens here? She recites what's called the Drake equation, a version, a cinematic version of the Drake equation. Drake equation is a great thing. It's a way to estimate how many civilizations there might be in the universe. And you start out with like the number of stars in the galaxy. In this movie, they use 400 billion, that's fine, 400 billion. Then you ask, what fraction of those total number of stars have planets? And what fraction of those with planets have life? What fraction of those planets that have life have intelligent life? And you just hack away at this large number, and at the end you come out with civilizations you might want to talk to. By the way, this is on actual location at the Arecibo telescope in Puerto Rico, where you can actually not only receive signals from aliens, you can reverse the telescope and send signals back out. Anyhow, here she is reciting the Drake equation. And apparently, it's turning both of them on.